Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Jock here from Awareness in Action. If you are listening on the podcast, then welcome. If you are watching on YouTube, then welcome. And if you haven't subscribed, then please do so. Subscribe on iTunes or subscribe on YouTube. And I actually, before I got that mixed up, I said in one of my videos, if you're listening on YouTube and watching on the podcast, but thank God I got it right this time. Anyway, guys, I've got a great episode today that we're going to talk about, coming from experience from some of my coaching people, some people I've been helping. Are you charging enough for your services? Whether you are a marketing agency, whether you are a coach, whether you are a tutor, or you know, maybe you're a spiritual worker, are you actually charging enough for your services, or are you living in fear? That's what we're going to get into when we come back. So join me. And if you're a coach, I've got something for you at the end. So please join me when we come back, and we're going to get straight into it. Are you charging enough for your services? God bless. Welcome back. Okay. I don't know about you guys. I've come across so many people just this week alone that are, I can't charge that enough. A colleague of mine in the UK, I can't charge that because that's not what people are used to paying around here. Someone who's running their own marketing company, it wants to undercharge themselves. A coach that I know who was charging nowhere near what they were worth. Are you charging enough, or are you governed by other people's perceptions? Are you governed? I'll say that again. Take my teeth out. Are you governed by other people's expectations of what should be? The reality is, if you are living by their expectations, then you are a sheep in a pen. You're following everyone. You're living according to what they expect you, and you have no freedom. You're not free. Okay. And therefore, what happens is you are caught on this cycle of abuse of yourself, a prisoner of your own self, where you do not value what you are worth. You don't value what you should be charging. And I've been there. I mean, I run a marketing agency. I coach, but I run a marketing agency, and it took me a while to try and recognize the work that I did and what I should be worth and why I should be paid for the service that I give. Because here's the thing, we live in a fear-based world, and we're fearful because we think, well, the reality is that they might not pay that, and if I quote them that, then I can go down, or what it is I'll go in low and hopefully I'm going to get it because I need this job. I need this income to come in. And you're living by that fear of what you need to come in. And people know that, and people will actually play on that. And they'll play on the idea they're trying to get everything as cheap as they possibly can to have gold service. It came to me in a hard way. And then I got to the point where, okay, if you can't afford it, then don't do it. Because obviously you're not willing to invest in yourself or your company. This is what I charge. I can play with it a little bit. But I deserve to charge this for what I'm actually giving you. It goes back to the old adage, the old story about the printing, the printing publishing press place where their machines broke down, and then they had to get someone to come in and fix them. They couldn't fix them, and then eventually they got their old retired engineer that came in, and he came in and he was there for 2 minutes, and he hit one place with a hammer and the printing press started up. And the CEO of the company was really, really happy. The CEO was delighted because that was them back in business. But here's the thing. When the CEO had the old man's invoice, it was basically $10 or £10, whatever your currency is for the hammer, and say $1,000 for being there. And of course the CEO went nuts because you're only there for 5 minutes. But when you explain it, when the old man explained it, as the story goes, it was $10 for the hammer, but it was $1,000 for the knowledge of where to hit at the right place to get the printing press to get up and running. And if nobody had known that, the printing press would never have opened, it would never have started again, and the company start to make money. It doesn't matter how long something takes. It doesn't matter what tools you use to make the job easier. The reality is the service that you're given is valuable to that person in many ways. So you have to ask yourself, when you are quoting for a marketing contract or a coaching contract or something like that, are you in the point where you're so scared that you don't value what you're worth and you're forever going out there and trying to see what others are charging and going below? Let's say it's $1,000, $1,500 or something, or $1,000 a month for your marketing or your coaching. And you go out there and you think, oh, Sally's only charging 500. Maybe I should just be 700 or I should be 500. No. Why are you living by their expectations? Why are you living by other people's expectations? You are you and you're different. Your voice has its own audience. Your knowledge is unique to that person. You could be thinking outside the box for your client. I do. I use all sorts of tactics and even intuitions and different things that I come up with, different ways I have that are not mainstream to help clients. That's what makes me unique, and you are unique. And because you're unique, you have to have it, you have to believe in yourself. I have a saying that I teach everyone: perceive, believe, conceive. Perceive it in your heart. Believe that God or Spirit has given it to you. Believe that it's part of you. Believe that the seed is there, and conceive it into reality. Perceive, believe, conceive. That is the same way when you are believing in what you're worth. So don't sell yourself short. Don't sell yourself short at all. If you want $1,000 a month, $1,500 a month, $5,000 a month, then go for it. And be, and it doesn't matter what anybody else is charging. Base it around the service that you give, the ease of life that you give. I'm actually going to put this wee light on. The ease of life that you give. We've got a little bit of orange light on there. It's getting dark. It's because it's the first day of spring and it's lovely. I kept the windows open. I know she had lighting on here, but never mind. This is nice. So what I want to get down to, guys, is basically how you believe in yourself that you are capable of doing the job that is required and going above and beyond in service and knowing that you're worth what you're asking. An honest service with integrity, supporting your clients. You are worth more than what you think. Your one piece of information, your one piece of knowledge could be a life-changing thing for them. You could say one sentence or one word to someone and it sparks a seed in them, a reality in them that changes their existence and their life. There is no cost that can be put on that. The value is priceless to that person. Value yourself and value what you're given, and give freely, but give with no condition, love without condition. You will be remunerated, you will be rewarded. Don't be frightened to say this is what I'm worth. I mean, don't be ridiculous and say that you're worth $50,000 a month and you're only given $1,000 worth of work. There has to be balance in life. But if you are also burdened and laden by what everybody else expects or what everybody else is charging, you will never have a successful business. You will never be successful as a coach, and you will never be successful in what you are trying to achieve because you're living by others' expectations. Live on your own expectation. Walk your own path. Let the universe attract to you the people who will value you. Ask God, ask the universe to send you the right people. Don't be afraid to tell them what you're worth and what you're going to give them and how you're going to serve them, and serve them well. That's how you value your business. That's how you value your worth. So, ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to keep you too long, but I want you to think of something seriously about this. Stop looking at what everybody else is charging and start looking inside at what you're worth and value your service. Don't be frightened that that person is charging X and you should be there. Don't be frightened. I've had clients recently that were never ever going to make any money in their business because they weren't valuing themselves and they weren't charging anywhere near enough and they weren't even paying their bills. And don't be afraid to turn work down. I've been there. I'll say, okay, well, if you can't afford it, it's fine. You know, you don't need to, there's other people out there that you can go to. You don't have to be behold to anyone or held to anyone or anyone's expectations. You do not have to do it cheaply just to get the job because you think you need to hold on to it to pay your bills, because if your emotions and your energy and everything is in sync with your belief, you'll attract it, okay? You will attract the right people. So believe in yourself, ladies and gentlemen. Charge what you're worth and do not sell yourself short. Yes, there's gurus out there who'll tell you to go and check this course or that course and go and check out your competition and what they're charging. It doesn't really matter. You can have a guideline, but don't be afraid to turn work down until you get the right job. Don't be afraid to turn that down because you know what you're worth. 9 times out of 10, if you turn around a client and say, you can't afford me, or you know, if you can't afford it, then don't do it. Don't bother about it. Don't worry about it. If you're a coach and they start to nickel and dime you, then you don't want to work with these people anyway, okay? They have to value you and you have to value you. And 9 times out of 10, they will come back to you because you will have given them something that no one else has. And then they will want to work with you. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've got any questions, please write them below. Connect with me on Instagram at JockBrokus. Ask me any questions. And I look forward to chatting with you all soon. And just if you are a coach, then get yourself over my invitation to you to coachandsupportgroup.co. And you can join other coaches there. This is a new community for coaches only. And go there. There's no charge to it. Come and join us. Interact with other coaches and maybe even collaborate with some of them. So have a wonderful evening, guys. I'm going to shut off because it's very dark. At least you can see me. I haven't got lighting on in here. And I'm very sorry about that, but I'm not changing because it was a beautiful evening. God bless.